allowed to be in, you definitely are down with the program. You're going to push some Coca-Cola, some Sprite. You're going to push some...
dance a little bit.
Yeah, you so you definitely, you know, and they definitely going to exploit your ass like the music.
You have to own the music, all parts of it. From the production, the studios, the engineers, to the technology that you print it on, the manufacturer, the distribution, all should be inside close parameters with people that you know in order that we can control the whole of the message and to stop the messages that are derogatory, that don't mean any good for our people. That's how you do it. Because how that escaped us is because they own hip-hop. They own hip-hop. George Bush owns hip-hop in the U.S. The corporations, Sears and them own hip-hop. Seagrams own hip-hop. A whole bunch of people, not black people, do not own hip-hop. You follow the money trail, you think the rappers are being rich, they're lying and faking. The richest people around hip-hop are the white people who own the rappers.
You shouldn't separate the culture of hip-hop from the business and the empowerment that comes with, you know, the economic potential of hip-hop. Because that's the problem, is when we first started doing hip-hop, so to speak, we were just doing it for the culture. We weren't concerned about the business, and then somebody came along that was concerned about the business, and now we are held hostage as a culture by people who don't give a fuck about this culture. So we do have to look at hip-hop as something that can empower us economically, you know what I mean? And we don't need to demonize that.
The brothers and sisters here have little or no idea how powerful they are in the hip-hop nation. I say that to say, all around the world, nodding their heads to what people are saying. So when you're conscious of that, then, you know, you can do more than just say, this is a hustle, I'm trying to make my bread, or that broad got a big ass. Come on.
Yeah.
There's more important things in the world. I know you would stick to it every day.
That's right.
But, you know, I know y'all ain't on MTV.
Exactly.
You dig? You ain't on BET.
Right, exactly.
And the reason why you ain't, because you're conscious.
Yeah.
And they don't want that out there.
Yeah, yeah.
See, but thank goodness there are other outlets.
And websites, and these allow virtual communities, and that allow people to have constituency, you know what I mean, or you know, have a fan base or customers or whatever your angle is, directly, you know what I mean, where you used to have to go through these people who monopolize the market because they, you know, Tower Records got all the real estate, you know where they house the CDs, and that's the only convenient way, you know, to go get it. So you gotta have a relationship with Tower Records before to get your music out. And how you get a relationship with Tower Records? You gotta go through a record company who's got a relationship with them because they want their catalog. You understand? So it's a whole infrastructure that had basically is not failed, but it's being rivaled by technology. You know what I mean? And hip hop play a key role because it's making that infrastructure billions of dollars, and now you just put that technology in an accessible form to the millions of us that are doing that. So, and then you couple that with people who've been selling dope and motherfucking hustling hard, you know, $2 out of nothing, you know what I mean, for all our lives, and you give us that technology. Now we got a story to tell already, we got the means to do it, and we got the business nuts to want to own it and control it, you know what I mean? So you got a new time, a revolution in a certain way, you know, that's going down with this hip hop movement. With, you know, through our company, Boss Up Inc., you know what I mean, which is basically our step toward Garvey moving, you know, trying to be independent and take control of our careers and always be able to make the decisions on what we gonna put out, how it's gonna come, and not be censored, you know what I mean, or stifled, you know, by depending on the system or the majors or the industry. So that's what Boss Up Inc. is about, and it's basically multimedia, different ways we can use information and entertainment together, you know what I mean, to get our point across build, you know, in a real sense, you know what I mean, and economically and just ideologically, you know, with what we're doing.
When you're going through changes, always remember that everything changes. It's gonna be some rain, it's gonna be some pain. No way around it, it's a part of the game. But you ain't by yourself, everything happened for a reason. Have hope, keep your faith, we just going through a season. Take a deep breath, center yourself. Courage over fear, any kind of way I can help. I'm right here.
I never knew the significance of the red, white, and blue flag. I was just taught to stand up and pledge allegiance.
I'll stand up for the pledge of allegiance to the flag. I said, stand up! You're American, aren't you?
Nope, that's your flag.
I never knew that the politics behind the policies of the government and how I relate to the poverty in my life, the CIA with the drugs in my community. I never knew, you know, the history of the Klan as it relates to the government and the history of just the racist power structure from his time and Garvey time and before that, you know what I mean? And just even slavery and why did they have slavery? And that it was about power more than it was about racism.
We're not being taught to deal with the world as it is. We're being taught to deal with this fairyland, which we're not even living in anymore. It's sad, because I'm telling you, and it should not be me telling you. It should be common knowledge. Aren't they wondering why death rates are going up and suicide is going up and drug abuse? Aren't they wondering? Don't they understand that more people are, I mean, more kids are being handed crack than they're being handed diplomas?
School to me was not a place that was full of life. It felt empty. It felt spiritless from the beginning. I always loved to learn, but I didn't see the school building as a place where you learn. I saw it as a popularity show, a fashion show. A place where you kick it with your peers and are influenced by what people's likes and wants are. But I didn't see it as a process by which I was going to get a gainful experience in learning anything. Some of my favorite subjects were math and science because they were very exact. Because numbers don't lie, or they're not supposed to.
What they tend to do is teach you reading, writing, arithmetic, then teach you reading and writing arithmetic again, then again, just making it harder and harder, just so to keep you busy. And that's where I think they messed up. There should be a class on drugs. It should be a class on sex education, a real sex education class, not just pictures and diaphragms and unlogical terms and things like that. There should be a drug class, there should be sex education, there should be a class on scams, there should be a class on religious cults, there should be a class on police brutality, there should be a class on apartheid, there should be a class on racism in America, there should be a class on why people are hungry, but they're not. Their class is on gym, you know, physical education, let's learn volleyball, because one day we're going to, you know, it's their class is like algebra. Where I've yet to go to a store and said, can I have X, Y plus 2 and give me my Y change back, thank you.
So for me, school was about passing the day, kind of staying in between those who wanted to just wild out and those who were kind of at the front of the class pretending to learn. And maybe I could stay somewhere in between and kind of coast my way through that. And that's pretty much what happened with me in my formal American education experience.
17 years old in Tallahassee, Florida, coming from Brooklyn, New York, finding out that I didn't need to be in school because the only thing that the schools would be able to teach me is how to be a clone, a drone, a worker, a cog in the system, a brick in the wall, if you will. And so all of my friends who graduated from high school with me either went to the Army, Navy, Air Force, the Marines.
I wanted to be in the U.S. Army. You know what I mean? Before I read Malcolm X's autobiography and I ain't had no knowledge of self, I wanted to be a soldier in the Army. You know what I mean? I wanted to learn, you know what I mean, you know, how to kill shit, how to destroy shit.
Me, I said, I'm going to try to get out of here and go to college. I
guess I haven't been smart enough to try to use that as an option. When I got down to Florida A&M University in Tallahassee, Florida, I realized that it was all a dream.
Because they get us into college and they say, well, you know, you should, you know, this is, becomes the whole idea. You could graduate and get a job. You can get a job. You can move out of your community, have bourgeois aspirations, middle class aspirations that don't have nothing to do with our community. Matter of fact, get away from there, young man. Get away from there. And so that's so far from the idea that I had.
A school is like a 12-step brainwash camp. They make you think if you drop out, you ain't got a chance to advance in life. They try to make you pull your pants up. Students fight the teachers and get took away in handcuffs. And if that wasn't enough, then they expel you. All your peoples understand it, but to them, you a failure. Observation and participation, my favorite teachers. When they beat us in the head with them books, it don't reach us. Whether you break dance or rock, sway to lead us.
Or be in the bathroom with your click, smoking reefer, then you know they mad class. Ain't important unless you add enough cash and multiples. Unemployment ain't rewarding. They may as well teach us extortion. You either get paid or locked up. The principal is like a warden in the 4 year sentence. Mad niggas never finish, but that doesn't mean I couldn't be a doctor or a dentist.
They schools can't teach us shit. My people need freedom. We trying to get all we can get. All my high school teachers can suck my dick, telling me white man lies, straight bullshit. They schools.
School has become an exercise in futility. When I say day schools, I'm talking about not the schools inside our community, because there's so many charter schools. There's so many independent schools. There's so many revolutionary schools. Education is not, does not just happen inside the four walls that they call a state educational environment. We continue to learn no matter what. The best education that I ever received was a revolutionary education.
This U.S. government-funded educational system preparing us to go out to the world and create more opportunities for capitalist exploitation over the world, to be drones, to work in aid, and their jobs that would go on and make their job, make their corporations bigger and bigger, while the gap between the people who were rich and the people who were poor became wider and wider. I saw that. I saw that from one or two semesters ago. I was clear.
It is better for us to go to our own schools, and after we have a thorough knowledge of ourselves, of our own kind, and racial dignity has been instilled within us, then we can go to anyone's school and we'll still retain our race pride, our racial dignity, and we will be able to avoid the subservient inferiority complex that most Negroes have or are, that is instilled within most Negroes who receive this sort of integrated education.
Malcolm Garvey Huey study, not just Malcolm Garvey Huey, but study Malcolm Garvey Huey.
You know what I mean?
Make that,
just three.
Make that your business.
Malcolm Garvey Huey.
Dedicated to all political prisoners.
Life is like a movie. Study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey.
It's Jake's the grill. Jake's back.
Life is like a movie.
Free Bovia.
I die. I organize. Everything I do's revolutionize. I build what's good for the whole damn hood. Study G's like these. Really think you should. I study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey. Marcel Cody with the Uzi. Listening to Fela Kuti. I'm a goon with the machete. Especially if it's deadly, got the Santos for the Hexy to protect me, so respect me. This is,
you know what I mean? I found Malcolm X book just looking on the shelf. I seen a book with an X on it, picked it up. Nobody had never told me about Malcolm X. I never heard about Malcolm X. I just picked it up, you know what I mean? And I can't put it down, you know what I mean? And just his story, you know, and just how much integrity he had as a person and how clear he broke down our situation. You know what I mean? It was just like, that shit just got me focused.
You study Malcolm for his integrity, you know what I'm saying? For his courage, you know what I mean? His ability to transform, you know what I mean?
Who are you? You don't know. Don't tell me Negro, that's nothing. What were you before the white man named you a Negro? And where were you? And what did you have? What was yours? What language did you speak then? What was your name? It couldn't have been Smith or Jones or Bunch or Powell. That wasn't your name. They don't have those kind of names where you and I came from. No, what was your name? And why don't you now know what your name was then? Where did it go? Where did you lose it? Who took it? Then how did he take it? What tongue did you speak? How did